Hello, and welcome to my reaction to episode 9 of Ibane Renmei. Last episode was another sad, depressing one, I guess, drama one. Raka is going down the rabbit hole of depression. And literally going down the rabbit hole as she fell into a well. Well, she descended into a well and got stuck. The question is, how are the others going to find her? I'm gonna assume that the crows are gonna help them, but who knows? So anyway, episode 9, Cold Ghost version. I guess I'm seeing that the length of this episode is also cut short. It's 21:32, so I imagine they skipped the opening and the ending again. But this is the same version that's on Kiss Anime, so whatever. I don't really like fansub doing that. Actually, I hate it. I hate when fansub cut the opening and the ending like that. But yeah, whatever. This is the version I have, so let's just keep going. So, episode 9, let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. Yeah, you keep saying that. It doesn't mean much, I feel like. Well, reverse riddle. Okay. Oh. Okay. Lucky, and maybe unlucky. I mean, I'm sure if you jump, you can grab that one. That was terrible. She went to get something to help her. Okay. Being nicer than anticipated. Hopefully another one doesn't break and she fall on his head. As always, they won't talk. Ouf. Well, I guess if she doesn't do shit like that, the plot is not gonna advance. We're not gonna be revealed anything. So. Okay, well. We've literally been revealed nothing. She's gonna need one out of a shower. After how many times she fell down. I mean, I guess they got her out of the well, but she's still lost, so. Of course, she would make it to the wall. I mean, there's no way to scare it. Oh shit. Okay. I mean, wasn't she in the first place not supposed to talk to you either? I mean, I'd like to believe that. that really. Is being way less antagonistic than I was expecting. I mean, with all the questions she's asking and stuff like that, I was expecting her to be punished, maybe, you know. I'm saying it again, but it's way more understanding and nice than I was expecting. Answer some question, please. Don't say that's how it works. I mean, by that logic, no, but the classic. Okay. Yeah, very unexpected. He's being way more helpful. We're not really being revealed anything from the mystery. You know, despite nothing really being answered of the mystery, this was pretty good. That's a pretty good encounter. was really smooth. And slapper. No, okay. I mean, shit. Oh shit. Is there something with that? I mean, I did not see that scene where she touched the wall as anything special. I guess it was. Fuck. I mean, I'd like to say that if they all know about it, why wasn't it something that was said to Rekha not to do? I mean, I'm sure she would have done it anyway, but... Interesting. Because despite everything, her mind is a bit more at peace now. Imagine Rekha tried to do the same. They've already said that she tried to run away, so the same probably happened to her. Very interesting. Definitely need some sleep after everything. Wet? You're no longer wet. I mean, it's the classic anime character thing where they have no reason to withhold information, but they still do anyway. And that always leads to something bad. I was going to say, what is that? So she isn't Sinbad anymore. How does that work? And you are still? She goes in the dark. Okay. And that's it. No ending. Just cut like that. Okay. I mean, yeah, the point of this episode was like a fun piece a bit, I guess. But I'm still a bit confused about this whole shit of Sinbound and shit. Like, it's a bit weird. If all it takes, like the old man said, is if you acknowledge your sin, then it's fine. Then why the fuck would Reki still be Sinbound? But at the same time, they keep saying that they have sin, but what even is it? What even did they do? Like, Rekka seemed to have such a strong, seemed to understand so much from this small vision, this small dream of her falling down. Like, she seemed to think she has a sin, she's someone, there was someone she cared about. I mean, this is definitely not what I interpret when I watch that dream or that vision of her falling down. It's a bit weird. I'm a bit confused though, where she pulled out all that shit. But still, that was one of the best episodes so far. We did not get any answer really. We're still at the same point. But I really liked the conversation with the old man. That was good. Yeah, anyway, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.